Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen wa salatu wa salamu ala sayyidina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa man tabi'ahum bi ihsanin ila yawmiddin amma ba'd. As this beautiful month is about to come to a close, naturally it's been an interesting and unique month. We continue to pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is a month, Allah says, ayyaman ma'dudat, a certain specific number of days. And essentially the goal, right, our goal in this month is what? La'allakum tattaqoon, so that we may acquire taqwa, the consciousness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And what else is our mission? Our mission is forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Everything that we are required to do in this month, the fasting, the prayers, the recitation, all of that is to become close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And if we have been able to become close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the unique situation that we happen to be in, then inshallah we are amongst those who are the winners and those who are successful. And if we haven't been able to come close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then it's not too late. Because all it takes is one sincere moment, literally a sincere moment, to remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah reminds us, udu'u rabbakum tadarru'an wa khufya. Right? Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala silently, with lots of humility. Find that one moment with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and all will be good inshaAllah. So there's a few things. First of all, you know, as we close these nights, we've been reminded again and again, again and again, let us increase our dhikr of Allahumma innaka afuwun tuhibbul afwa fa'afu anni. O Allah, innaka afuwun, you are the one who forgives. Tuhibbul afwa, you love to forgive, so forgive me. Make this dua in any language. Aisha radiallahu anha narrates this from the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And it's been narrated that Sufyan Thawri, who writes, for me, dua in this night is better than prayer. Now that doesn't mean that he wouldn't pray. It would just mean that he personally would find a certain satisfaction in dua that he would not find in prayer on this specific night. Right? So whatever it is that we do, dua, dhikr, charity, waking up a little early for suhoor so that we can get in our tahajjud, whatever it is extra that we can do during these nights, let's make it count. We just have a few more nights left. We're almost there. And inshallah, the blessing is with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Also, keeping in mind that no one should end this month with a feeling of guilt. No one should end this month feeling that what they have done has not been accepted. No one should end this month feeling that this Ramadan was not a good Ramadan, or this Ramadan was a bad Ramadan. There's no such thing as a bad Ramadan. There's no such thing as not a good Ramadan. There's no such thing as my actions have not been accepted by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Though we are reminded that there would be people, as I mentioned earlier, who would make dua for 6 months after Ramadan for Allah to accept their ibadah of their Ramadan. But that means, inshallah, that Allah will accept our ibadah. So I don't want anyone to end this month of the blessed month of Ramadan, this beautiful month of Ramadan, thinking that my actions weren't accepted, I wasn't able to go to the masjid, so I didn't get my extra rewards, that I wasn't able to host people for iftar, so I won't get that extra reward. Whatever actions that we have been able to do in the past that we haven't been able to do this month should not be a reason for us to think that this was not a good Ramadan, this was not a fulfilling Ramadan, simply because we weren't able to do those actions. And we would have had we had the ability to do so, inshallah, we have our reward with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala without even doing them. And the fact that we want to do them and we aren't able to do them, then inshallah, there's an increase in our reward with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Do not underestimate the power of Allah. Do not underestimate the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is not a time to be having negative thoughts about Allah. This is a time about having having positive thoughts about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the acceptance from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is what leads us into our Eid, right? This is what leads us into our Eid. It's been mentioned, Abdullah ibn Abbas radiallahu anhuma narrates, and we want to talk about the last night of Ramadan. We don't know when it will be, naturally moon sighting. So whichever night it is, Abdullah ibn Abbas radiallahu anhu narrates that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, at iftar on each night in Ramadan, hundreds of thousands of individuals are freed from the fire of hell. But on Friday, that many people are freed every moment. And when the last night of Ramadan arrives, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala frees and forgives the amount of people that He has freed and forgiven during the course of the entire month. So if just in case, we haven't made it into that list, all we got to do is get that last moment of Ramadan, right? That last day. If tonight is the sighting of the moon, then make sure that we are, while we make arrangements to sight the moon and fulfill that sunnah, but let us make sure that we spend a few moments alone with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, asking Him for forgiveness. Allah will not allow any believer who asks Him for forgiveness to not be forgiven during this blessed month. All we have to do is ask. So, and if it's not that night, and if we complete 30 nights, then of course we know for a fact that Eid will be the next day. Then on the 30th night, evening of Ramadan, before Salat al-Maghrib, make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the acceptance of our deeds, right? For the acceptance of our deeds, for forgiveness, for a blessed future, that may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala relieve the ummah, relieve the entire earth with the difficulty that it happens to be going through, right? Asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And as we're talking about dua, and as all of us make dua in our homes, with our families, with our children, with our parents, I ask you to keep me and my family in your blessed du'as as well. Now also keep in mind that the nights of Eid, right, are considered to be nights of ibadah and worship. Right, these are nights of ibadah and worship. The Prophet, it's been narrated that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, although Ramadan would technically be over at the time of Maghrib, he wouldn't go home. He would remain in the masjid, go directly to the musalla for Eid, and then proceed to his home from there. Abu Umamah radiallahu anhu narrates that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, whoever stands in prayer in the nights of Eid for the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, his heart will not die on the day, all the hearts will die. In other words, if we can take a few moments on the night of Eid after Isha, just as we have been praying Taraweeh every day, and we have been making tahajjud every day, if we can take a few moments and pray a few extra rak'ahs, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will cause and allow our hearts to always be alive, always be conscious, aware of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, aware of our surroundings, aware, right, of the reality of this life, aware of the importance of the hereafter, insha'Allah. Mu'adh ibn Jabal radiyallahu anhu narrates that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, paradise, Jannah, is mandated, compulsory for the one who keeps five nights alive. The night of Tarwiyah, the night of Arafah, the night of two Eids, and the night of Bara'ah. So keep in mind that this, the night of Eid, happens to be a night of ibadah and worship. Let's also keep in mind a few things. If we haven't given our Sadaqatul Fitr, although it becomes an obligation on the day of Eid, at Fajr time, we can give it in advance. If you are aware of poor and needy people in the community that you can get it to directly so that they can enjoy Eid as well, let us try to do that. So if we haven't given our Sadaqa al-Fitr, Zakat al-Fitr, Fitra, Fitrana, whatever it is you call it, let's try to make sure that we take care of that sooner than later. Also, keep in mind, there is a minimum amount. The Hanafis have the most, the bare minimum amount, but you know, we say minimum of $5, but give as much as you can. If you can give more, please go ahead and do so. Also, it seems Eid this year may be very, very, very unique and very, very different. Rather than be sad about it, honestly, let us be grateful that we are alive. Let us be grateful that we are healthy. Let us be grateful that we have shelter. Let us be grateful that we have people that love us. Let us be grateful that we have had this entire month of Ramadan. Let us be grateful that we have been able to fast. Let us be grateful that if we haven't been able to fast, we've been able to give the fidyah. Right, we've been able to give the fidya, that lengthy hadith, the Nabi, an individual made a mistake, had to give a kafara, comes to the Prophet ﷺ, and the Prophet ﷺ gives him all these options. In the end, right, he couldn't fulfill any of the options, not even given charity. And when dates were brought in charity, the Nabi ﷺ asked for him and said, give this to that man so he can give these dates in charity. And he responds to the Prophet ﷺ, he says, oh Messenger of God, give this to a family that's poorer than my family. So let us be grateful that for those of us that haven't been able to fast, we were able to give the fidya. There's so much to be grateful for. There's so much to celebrate, right? I just received word from someone who says that all of a sudden they've lost eyesight in one of their eyes. Subhanallah, we have so much to be grateful for. Yes, unfortunately we cannot celebrate with the community at the masjid or at the fairgrounds or at some large hall where we have all dressed up and we're with our family and friends and saying takbirat of Eid and so on and so forth. I get that. I totally understand that. We're totally going to miss that. This Ramadan and this Eid is going to go down in history like never before. But let us, inshallah, be grateful for all that which we have. And I'm going to recommend, especially parents of young children, make it a celebration. Decorate your homes. Please, for the sake of Allah, because this Ramadan and Eid has been so difficult for all of us. Let us buy gifts for our children. Let's buy some nice gifts for our children. Let them remember that it was that one Eid that was so difficult that I was able to, my parents got me something that I had wanted for such a long time. If Allah has blessed you with the opportunity, be grateful and buy beautiful gifts for your children and decorate your homes. And make this Eid one of celebration, because we want to make sure that we celebrate from the bottom of our hearts and we remain in a state of gratitude to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Say, Ya Allah, despite all the difficulty, you've given us so much and we want to be grateful today and we want to celebrate. Please dress up. If you wish to buy new clothes, please buy new clothes. Please dress up. And then when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allows us the opportunity once again to see each other, meet each other, greet each other, hug each other, and have dinner with each other, we will do that, inshallah. We will make qada of our Eid, not the Eid prayer, but qada of the celebration of our Eid. We will, inshallah, whenever we can, with our MCC community, inshallah, we and all the other surrounding communities that Livermore, San Ramon, and everyone else, inshallah, we will collectively celebrate. We'll have an Eid celebration, inshallah, all of us, and we will celebrate and we will eat good food and we will smile and we will laugh. But let us make this Eid a blessed one for all of us, inshallah. We pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the acceptance of this beautiful month of Ramadan, and let us ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive us in this month and to become pleased with us and to remain pleased with us and allow us to be in His blessings and allow us to keep all of the blessings that He has given to us and not take away anything away from us, and allow us to have halal sustenance and increase our sustenance and give shifa to those who are ill. I know there's many people in the Tri-City community or Tri-Valley community that are very near and dear to my heart who are very, very ill. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless all of you and all of us, our parents and our elder ones, with shifa and afiyah and blessings and happiness. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make this Ramadan a beautiful one for all of us and a beautiful Eid for all of us. With that said, a few days in advance, inshallah, Eidukum Mubarak, Eid Mubarak to all of you. Kullu am wa antum bi khair. Please keep me and those near and dear to me in your du'as, and you will all be in mine. Jazakumullahu khairan, barakallahu fikum, salamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh.